Oh my God, bro. Okay, genuinely. Yes, okay, let's go. Machine learning specialization by Andrew Ng and three more instructors. So, okay, how much is Andrew Ng actually teaching? Well, we'll have to take a look at that. But offered by DeepLearning.AI and Stanford, it is going to be phenomenal because it's in Python, okay? That's what we were missing for so long. Coursera is amazing because it has all of these friendly exercises and material, and then you have to do these assignments. But who wants to do an assignment in MATLAB? I don't want to use MATLAB or Octave, it's the same thing. Python, there we go. Okay, so taking a look at it for the very first time together, what you will learn: build ML models with NumPy and Scikit-Learn, which are Python libraries. Build and train supervised models for prediction and binary classification tasks, linear and logistic regression. Perfect. Build and train a neural network. Okay, that's interesting. We're actually going into neural networks, which is a deep learning topic, okay, because you did see DeepLearning.AI. It didn't used to be deep learning. It used to be just straight up machine learning or classical methods. So what he's most likely going to do is go just a little bit into the like a base neural network probably. And also you'll see here, of course, perform multi-class classification, but decision trees and ensemble methods. Okay, this is going to be huge because most of the Andrew Ng stuff before didn't really go too into the tree-based methods, or actually, I don't think they really talked about them at all. But some of the most popular machine learning methods are these decision tree and tree ensemble methods, like gradient boosting, random forests. I have a strong suspicion he's going to talk about both of those things, so really excited about that. Apply best practices for ML development and use unsupervised learning techniques for unsupervised learning, including clustering and anomaly detection. Okay, absolutely critical. You know, all the supervised learning stuff going to be up here, the most common unsupervised learning stuff down here. Still in Python, absolutely wonderful. And build a recommender system, also generally classified as unsupervised learning. And a deep learning method, build a deep reinforcement learning model. Oh my God. Bro, okay, genuinely, a deep reinforcement learning model? That is freaking awesome. I can't believe they did that. Oh, Andrew Ng, you are just a wonderful man. Okay, skills you will gain: decision trees, artificial neural network, logistic regression, recommender systems, linear regression, regularization to avoid overfitting. Okay, genuinely, this is why I love this man, because he is not putting this as some sort of a buzzword to kind of trick the Coursera system to get his course to work. He wrote a tag as regularization to avoid overfitting. He's actually telling you what this thing is. He's not trying to just grab people and make some, you know, BS type of thing. He's just making it, you know, straight up, this is what you'll learn, and he's awesome. Oh my God, yes. Okay. XG boost. Wow. I'm already blown away. This is exactly what we were hoping for. Oh my God. Okay, courses. So there are three courses in the specialization. Course one, supervised machine learning, regression, and classification. I'm going to take a quick look at that course. Okay, we have week one, which is 7 hours to complete. Welcome to machine learning applications. What is machine learning? Supervised learning, unsupervised learning, Jupyter notebooks, linear regression, cost functions, visualization, gradient descent, learning rate, all of the stuff that you'd want to see here. There it is. Okay, yeah, perfect. It'll be relatively similar to what he did before, but all of this stuff is going to be modernized and in Python when you have assignments to do. Regression with multiple input variables. Okay, so this is where you start talking about vectorization and using multiple features and how that works. That's something that's really important to understand. Polynomial regression, you know, not super commonly used, but something that's very important to understand theoretically. Okay, week three, classification. That seems like a pretty obvious next step. Motivations, logistic regression, decision boundary, cost functions for logistic regression, simplified cost function, gradient descent, overfitting, and of course, underfitting, regularization, linear regression, and logistic regression. Regularize. Okay, we needed that. Oh, this is just going to be amazing. That amazing first course. I'm not reviewing the actual material, but what he's talking about here is exactly what you would want. So that is wonderful. Let's go over to the second course. Okay, second course. is advanced learning algorithms. Well, yeah, we're seeing TensorFlow, so neural networks to perform multi-class classification, best practices for machine learning development, so your models generalize to data and tasks in the real world, and build and use decision trees and tree ensemble methods. Okay, we already saw a little bit about what this is. Okay, week one is actually neural networks. That's kind of crazy. Like, you wouldn't expect him to do this, but code up your own neural network in Python from scratch. Wow. And then you can learn about how they're implemented efficiently using parallel processing or vectorization, which you should learn about to make sure that you do try to do that. Neurons on the brain, so basically the mix between the biological aspect and how that inspired neural networks in machine learning. Demand prediction, recognizing images, wow. Neural networks, more complex neural networks, forward propagation, inference, forward prop in a single layer, general implementation. Is there a path to AGI? Oh my, that's artificial general intelligence, which is basically something that we're kind of scared of. Matrix multiplication. I'm kind of surprised that he's putting that there, but I guarantee you that this is organized in a way so that that you're okay if this is near the end here. Some quizzes that are going to be in Python. There you go. Implementing neural network in Python. So happy to see that. Neural network training. So I'm going to go a little bit faster now, but basically all of the common activation functions in neural networks and advanced optimization and layer types. So he's getting more and more advanced into neural networks, which is kind of crazy. I'm surprised at how far he's going in there. Advice for applying machine learning. Okay, this stuff is really, really important. Diagnosing bias and variance, cross-validation. I'm surprised he's actually talking about this here. But again, I'm sure that he picked a very specific reason for this. So evaluating models, training via cross-validation and test sets, bias and variance, regularization and bias and variance, establishing a baseline, and all about, I'm not going to read this, but all about how to get a better and better model and how to really understand what you're using. Trading off precision and recall at the end, really how to look at the proper metrics so that you can really evaluate your models. Okay, week four is decision trees. This week you'll learn about a practical and very commonly used learning algorithm, the decision tree. Woot. Oh, that's amazing. Okay, so there's a lot of stuff to put together here. It's going to be a lot of just in order various pieces, but decision trees, learning, purity, information gain, categorical variables, regression trees, optional. No, not optional. If you're going to do all of this, make sure you do regression trees as well. And all of these amazing things to work up to XGBoost, which please try to understand that. This section will be confusing. You know, this is going to be a little bit hard, I can tell you that. But it's really worth it, I promise. Okay, I believe that's it for that course. Yes, it is. So finally, we have course number three. Course number three is unsupervised learning. Okay, I'm just going to jump straight to the course and take a look at that. Week number one is untitled module, so I don't think they've quite figured this out yet, but you have a good feeling for what that is. Okay, so I believe that this course is ready to go, and you can start launching it at any point. I'm not going to launch it quite yet. If you get there and it actually says that you need to wait until tomorrow, then wait until tomorrow, and that's totally fine. I do have a link in the description if you want to take a look. This course is going to be amazing, okay? I am going to do another one where I kind of follow up and talk about the material itself as well. This was just kind of a first impressions. This is how I feel about it, and to let everyone know that it is available. Take a look. It's going to be amazing. And in terms of the certificate, like, you want to be one of the first people to get this certificate, because it's going to start to fill up and a lot of people are going to be doing it, and it will provide, you know, arguably more, but also less value over time as more and more people start to do it. So I would recommend, if you don't have some sort of a machine learning specialization thing on here, this holds a lot of value, especially saying that you understand the ensemble methods like XGBoost, and really neural networks, pretty into neural networks as well. Drop a like on the video so that everyone knows about this and everyone can go and learn about it, because it is phenomenal. Okay. All right. I will see you next time, guys. Have a great day.